Let's talk about Tailwind CSS, the topic that sparks more developer Twitter debates than the question, is HTML a programming language? Simply put, Tailwind CSS provides hundreds of utility classes, which are opinionated, single-purpose CSS classes that apply specific styles. Tailwind is sometimes confused with CSS frameworks like Bootstrap or Foundation. However, the main difference is that these frameworks provide styles for components like buttons, accordions, modals, and much more. Tailwind, on the other hand, doesn't provide any styled components, but is used to apply custom styles to components you build yourself. For example, in Foundation, you could pass the button class into a button element to get a styled button component. However, a button in Tailwind CSS looks like any other default HTML button because it's your job to apply custom styles. For example, to style the button like this, you would set a border radius, background color, left and right padding, top and bottom padding, font size, font weight, and font color. You can also style element states conditionally using modifiers like hover and focus visible. You can even use the dark modifier to apply styles when users have dark mode enabled. There are also modifiers for creating responsive designs. For example, the LG class sets styles for screens at a minimum width of 1024 pixels. It's worth noting that Tailwind CSS takes a mobile-first approach to responsive design. This means unprefixed utilities are applied to all screen sizes, while prefixed utilities are applied to that breakpoint and above. Although Tailwind CSS provides opinionated classes, it's easy to change them or add your own classes inside the Tailwind config file to build the design system you want. And if you don't want to add theme values inside the config file, you can pass in arbitrary values using the bracket syntax. Advocates of Tailwind CSS claim that they can build user interfaces more rapidly than traditional styling because of the out-of-box design system, never needing to leave your markup to add styles, and no more thinking of class names. Also, Tailwind CSS ensures that your production builds only ship with the needed classes, minimizing the bundle size and removing zombie CSS classes from going live. However, this utility-first approach leads to large, hard-to-read markup, especially for elements like inputs that require styling for multiple states. This downside alone can be a deal-breaker for many, but using Tailwind with components from your favorite front-end frameworks makes this less annoying to deal with because your markup is contained within a single component that can be reused throughout your application. Regardless, there are still plenty of critics of Tailwind CSS that note the missing support for various CSS properties and how it could stop you from learning CSS properly, especially if you're a beginner. Luckily for those still wanting to use Tailwind at this point, development environments like VS Code have useful extensions to make your life much easier. For example, the inline fold extension can be used to toggle long class names. Another example is the Tailwind CSS Prettier plugin, which organizes classes in an opinionated way with the help of the Prettier code formatter. And another, the Tailwind CSS IntelliSense extension, provides VS Code and Tailwind users advanced features such as autocomplete, syntax highlighting, and linting. Beyond developer tools, there's also a vibrant ecosystem around free and paid Tailwind UI component libraries that you can quickly incorporate into your next projects. In fact, Tailwind CSS has an official library called Tailwind UI, and some other notable mentions include HyperUI, Flowbyte, Preline, and Tailwind Elements. If you made it this far, it's probably time to give Tailwind a shot. And if you like this video, subscribe for more like this in the future. Happy coding, and I'll see you in the next one.